how to gradually slow down or speed up a video clip in Shotcut. Let's head over to the computer and get started.
So to demonstrate this, I have created a new Shotcut project, added a clip into the playlist, and then dragged the clip into the timeline. I'm now selecting that clip and coming up to filters, searching the time and clicking Time Remap. This is the filter we're going to use to gradually increase time over a video clip. So if I play this through now, you can see that it's playing fairly slowly and just going through, and the guys are playing football. If we go to our keyframes, you can see that the Time Remap has been added to the keyframe section. We can now use this to modify how time and keyframes are allocated. Okay, so first of all, if your clip is looking really small in your keyframes, then click on this button here. It will mean that it maximizes the space that you've got available to you and fits it all within the keyframes area. So click onto that and you'll see something similar to what I'm looking at now. You'll see that zero is at the bottom here and your first keyframe is at 0 seconds as well. The time is represented vertically. So this clip is about 15.3 seconds long. And as you can see, the keyframe is right at the very top. This represents the end of the clip. And this represents the beginning of the clip. But if I was to move this to here, this would still represent the end of the clip because it's at 15.3 seconds and the clip is physically 15.3 seconds long. So what this is doing is showing us how quickly the clip is being played through. So to demonstrate that, let me just play and you can see the full clip goes all the way through, but it plays in a fraction of the second than when this was all the way at the end here. So I hope that makes sense. First of all, you're looking at time going vertically over this filter. Then that begs the question, well, what's going across the other way? Well, these are your frames per second. This video clip was filmed in 25 frames per second. So there'll be 25 frames every second. And effectively what we're doing is we're either squashing them up if we're speeding up the time, or we're flattening them or lowering them if we are slowing down the time. Now, the human eye sees at roughly 24 frames per second. If you slow down something and it becomes less than 25 frames per second, it's going to start looking jolty and juddery. If I speed up the first part of this clip, which means we're going at 4x speed, but then the remainder of this clip is going to be going very slowly. So when you're at fast speed, it goes fine, but then when you're going slowly, it's going to look really jolty. And you may not want that effect. So to avoid that, you need to keep within the parameters that your video has been recorded in. If you're recording at 60 frames per second, you can go down to 30 frames per second, which means you can half the speed of your video. If you want to slow it down by up to 4x, then you would need to record your footage in 120 frames per second. But that is what you need to be aware of when you record, so your footage can then appear smoothly when you go through this effect.
Now, just before we continue, if we're meeting for the very first time, then my name is Joe and this channel helps YouTubers edit their videos and use free software. If you're creating YouTube videos regularly and not seeing the growth you'd hope for, you're probably missing one or more elements of the video creator framework. You can download the free PDF in the description below to get started. Now, let's get back to the video.
So let's imagine we now want to speed up our whole entire video. So the end of the video is 5 seconds long. So now it's going to play slowly and then it's going to play really fast here. Let's just look at that. So it's going in a little bit of slow motion and then really fast. Okay, you can tell if it's faster or slower by clicking wherever you want to check and then looking here. So that's a tiny bit of a speed increase. And then this is a massive speed increase to get to the result of 5 seconds. So if we're looking to ramp up slowly, you're going to want to create this time map that almost looks like an exponential graph. So you would start off playing it as much as possible at one time speed and then ramp up subsequent keyframes as you progress through the timeline. And what I'm doing here is moving my playhead to the right location, or to roughly where I think the keyframe needs to be, and then coming over and clicking on the keyframe icon to create another keyframe. Every time I create a new keyframe, I'm able to move that with my mouse to the desired location. And remember that you can use the Control and Alt buttons to fine tune the position of the keyframe. Okay, so I've just had a little play around with it. And now when you push play, you can see it starts off at normal speed and then it slowly ramps up throughout the duration of the full video clip. And as you can see, the line starts to get steeper and steeper. If you had a better view of this time graph here, then it would look almost like an exponential kind of graph. But because it's so oblongated, it does look a little bit obscure. So let me take you through. The first line just here is at just over 1% speed. So it's going just slightly faster. And then the next one is going at 1.6. The next one, 2.9, 4.2, 5.3, and then 6.2 to finish. So each time it's ramping up the speed in which it's playing. It also means that it finishes at roughly 5 seconds, which is what we wanted to happen. So all of this clip now is actually redundant. So make sure you click on the last keyframe that you want to keep and then go back to your timeline. That will position your playhead at the same location as the keyframe you just selected. So now you can split and get rid of the bit that you didn't want. If I click onto this clip and just go back into the keyframes, you can see that you've still got all of your work there. And then when you go back into your timeline, you've only got the clip that actually matters. So now when you push play, it speeds up and it speeds up and it speeds up and it plays the clip really fast, just within a few seconds. Now, there are quite a few things that you can do with this. If I go back to the keyframes, you can actually set, I'm just doing this as an example, but you can set it to go forwards and then back. And then it plays forwards again. So you can do lots of cool, funky things with this. And just remember that your time is along the vertical axis. So even though generally speaking, you're looking at the time along the timeline, when you're looking at this keyframe tool, you're looking at the time going vertically. You can obviously invert the keyframes that I made as well for it to go in reverse and speed up in reverse. Entirely up to you. I'll let you play around with the time remap filter yourselves, but that's how you gradually increase or decrease the speed of your clip in Shotcut.
Please consider liking and subscribing. And before you go, click or tap on the video on your screen right now, and it will continue to help you with Shotcut. I'll see you in the next video.